Canada's University Challenge. Asking the questions, Jeremy Paxman.
Hello. Our seasonal series for distinguished alumni continues with two more teams preparing to ding-dong merrily for a place in the next stage of the competition. Tonight, we'll pass the halfway point of these first-round matches so we can say with certainty that if the winning team of this match can score 185 or more, they'll definitely return to play in the semi-finals. Now, the first team member playing for the University of Nottingham may well be hoping for a set of bonus questions on ladybirds, given that she's co-led the UK Ladybird Survey for over 15 years and co-authored the Field Guide to the Ladybirds of Britain and Ireland. She's president of the Royal Entomological Society and is currently leading a global assessment of invasive non-native species for the UN Intergovernmental Panel on Biodiversity and Ecosystem Services. With her, a civil servant whose past appointments have included non-resident High Commissioner to the Kingdom of Tonga, the Republic of Kiribati and Tuvalu, and non-resident ambassador to the Federated States of Micronesia. Until August this year, she was also head of the South Pacific Network, leading the UK's engagement with the region. Their captain is, in fact, a major, having served in the Parachute Regiment for 13 years. As a writer and photographer, he's produced a number of best-selling books and documentary series detailing his quite extraordinary journeys on foot, including walking the length of the Nile, the length of the Himalayas, and making a circumnavigation of the Arabian Peninsula. He's an elected fellow of both the Royal Geographical Society and the Explorers Club, and is an ambassador and patron for a number of charities, including UNICEF. People on this series often have pleasurably grand job titles, perhaps none more so than their fourth player, who, among other things, is the Prince Consort Professor of Composition at the Royal College of Music, a former assistant to Benjamin Britten and colleague of the composer Imogen Holst. His own works include a cello concerto for Rostropovich and Renewal, a choral and orchestral work for the 50th anniversary of Radio 3. He is now the Halley Composer Emeritus, Executive Administrator of the Holst Foundation and Music Director of the Britten Peers Foundation. Let's meet the Nottingham team.
Hello, I'm Helen Roy, and I graduated with a PhD in ecology from the University of Nottingham in 1997, and I currently work as an ecologist at the UK Centre for Ecology and Hydrology.
Hello, I'm Melanie Hopkins. I graduated in 1995 with a BA in Modern Languages. I work for the Foreign, Commonwealth and Development Office, and my most recent role was as British High Commissioner to Fiji.
This is their captain.
Hello, I'm Levison Wood. I graduated from Nottingham in 2004 with a degree in modern history, and I'm now an author.
Hello, I'm Colin Matthews. I graduated in classics and archaeology in 1967, then moved to the music department where I took an MPhil in composition, and I'm a composer.
Now, the team from the University of Sheffield include a journalist who has held several roles at the newspaper he works for, including parliamentary sketch writer, television critic and restaurant reviewer. He's been shortlisted for the British Press Awards Broadsheet Columnist of the Year and Critic of the Year. Their next team member has been Professor of Legal Education at the University of Sheffield, and in 2013 she was shortlisted for the Oxford University Law Teacher of the Year Award. She's now a professor at Manchester University and runs the Manchester Innocence Project. Alongside her day job, their captain is a champion of women in science and is currently Cambridge University's gender equality champion. She was a fellow in the experimental physics division at CERN and is patron of the Gravity Fields Festival, held in honor of Isaac Newton. In 2005, she designed the Hunt the Higgs card game, in which players take the roles of Large Hadron Collider detectors, searching for the Higgs boson. Finally, a national news broadcaster, 2020 saw her co-host ITV's medical show On Call with Dr. Ranj Singh, and she's worked on documentaries and reported for both the Tonight and On Assignment programmes. Other posts have included a stint in New York as the US correspondent for ITV's Breakfast programme. So let's meet the Sheffield team now.
Hello, I'm Michael Deacon. I studied English literature at Sheffield, graduating in 2001. I'm now a columnist at the Daily Telegraph.
Hi, I'm Claire McGawley, and I graduated in 2002 with a PhD in law from Sheffield, and I now work at the University of Manchester.
This is their captain.
Hi, I'm Val. I graduated from Sheffield in 1983 with a degree in physics. I'm now Professor of High Energy Physics and Fellow of Trinity College, the University of Cambridge.
I'm Kylie Pentelow, and I graduated with an MA in print journalism from Sheffield, and I'm now a presenter at ITV.
All right, you all know the rules. It's 10 points for starter questions, 15 for bonuses. Starter questions have to be answered on your own, and bonuses are team efforts, so you can confer on those. So, fingers on the buzzers, here's your first starter for 10. Meanings of what five-letter word include a cloud of droplets, such as that thrown up by a waterfall, a jet of vapour or finely divided liquid, a sprig or a ray of flowers on one stem or twig?
Nottingham Hopkins.
A spray.
A spray is correct. You get bonuses on syndromes named after cities. Stendhal syndrome, where individuals experience palpitations or dizziness after seeing works of art, is also known by the name of which Italian city?
Florence
is correct. Observed during the 1996 Japanese embassy crisis and regarded as an inversion of the Stockholm syndrome, which South American capital gives its name to a syndrome in which hostage takers become sympathetic to their hostages?
South American city.
Caracas. Caracas. No, it's Lima. Proximity to holy sites in which Middle Eastern city is known to trigger a syndrome characterized by delusions or psychosis?
It's Jerusalem, surely.
Jerusalem
is correct. 10 points for this. Mero in Sudan, Tikal in Guatemala, Cholula in Mexico and Dashur to the south of Cairo are sites noted for what prominent monumental structures?
Nottingham Wood.
Pyramids.
Pyramids is correct, yes. Your bonuses are on films in which wintry weather plays a significant role. In each case, name the film from the description. Firstly, Ang Lee's 1997 adaptation of a novel by Rick Moody. It's set during an unusually cold Thanksgiving break in 1970s Connecticut.
So it's got ice in the title, but is it The Iceman or is it? It's got ice. Ice Age? No, I think that's good. That's a children's one, though, isn't it? Ice.
Yep,
ice suggestion of Iceman sounded good.
Iceman.
No, it's The Ice Storm. Produced by Howard Hawks, secondly, a 1951 science fiction film set in a remote Arctic research base. The frozen body of an alien is accidentally thawed by scientists who must then battle it. I need a five-word title here.
The Thing?
That was the remake, The Thing. Mm. It's The Thing from Another World. So, finally, the Coen brothers' 1996 comedy film noir involving kidnap, extortion and murder. It's set in the snowy plains of Minnesota.
Fargo.
Fargo is correct. 10 points for this. What given name links the following? The German-born author and screenwriter of films including A Room with a View, the biblical character who remained with her mother-in-law after she was widowed, and the US Supreme Court justice affectionately referred to as the notorious RBG.
Sheffield Gibson.
Ginsburg?
No. Anyone want to buzz from Nottingham?
Nottingham Hopkins.
Bader?
No, it was the third name. It was Ruth, in fact, I was looking for. Right, 10 points for this starter question. What three-letter modal auxiliary verb appears at the end of words meaning the nationality of President Porfirio Diaz, an oily North American nut used in pies, and a lively and risque dance, for example, in Orpheus's...
Sheffield Deacon.
Can.
Can is correct, yes. Your bonuses are on types of carrots, as described on the invaluable website, carrotmuseum.co.uk. Which type of carrot is described as short, brittle and high in sugar? It takes its name from a major city on the Loire estuary.
Chartreuse? Chartreux?
No, it's not. Secondly, which carrot type has, quote, vigorous foliage and long and slender roots? It shares its name with the title conferred upon victorious generals in the Roman Republic.
Pass.
It's Imperator. And finally, which carrot type has, quote, a conical shape with a well-defined shoulder tapering to a point? It shares its name with the surname of the housekeeper in Daphne du Maurier's Rebecca.
Chantal?
No, it's Danvers, as in Mrs. Danvers. Right, we're going to take a picture round now. For your picture starter, you're going to see a definition of a type of alcoholic drink written in the language of its country of origin. For 10 points, name the drink. You can give your answer either in English or in the language shown.
Nottingham Hopkins.
Sherry, Jerez Sherry.
Correct, yes. So, following on from that definition of sherry in Spanish, your picture bonuses are descriptions of three more foods and drinks commonly consumed at Christmas, each in the language of a country with which they're closely associated. 5 points for each you can work out. First, you may give me either a two-word name in English or a three-word name in French.
It's bouche. It's the long... OK, so it's the long cake that's rolled up like that. Isn't it bouche? Bouche de Noël?
Not
like
really.
It's Christmas roulade. Yeah, it could be a roulade. Yeah, roulade. Kind of Christmas.
Roulade.
Is that what it's called? Is that it's a Christmas?
Two like or
Christmas
three
what?
Words.
Two in English.
So I think it would be bouche de Noël in French, or Christmas roll would it be? Can you say Christmas roll? Should I have bouche de Noël?
Bouche de Noël.
Bouche de Noël is correct. Yes, Yule log in English. Yes. Secondly, I want a single Italian word which is also used in English.
Panettone
is correct. And finally, you can either give me a two-word English name or a single German word.
That's going to be Stollen, isn't it? I don't know, but let's... What else do we have from Germany?
It's Glühwein.
Glühwein.
It's got the red wine at the top.
Yeah.
Glühwein.
Glühwein is correct. Mulled wine. Well done. Answer promptly, giving the letter of the alphabet that begins the word for Christmas in Welsh, Irish, Catalan, Spanish and French.
Nottingham Hopkins.
The word for Christmas...
Come on.
Español, E.
I didn't ask for that.
Sheffield Gibson.
N.
N is correct, yes, N for November. Right, here are your bonuses then, Sheffield. Quote, he was never more sinister than when he was most polite. The elegance of his diction, even when he was swearing, showed him one of a different caste from his crew. These words from a children's novel of 1911 describe which literary villain?
Silver.
No, it's Captain Hook. Subtitle A Winter's Tale, which novel by Robert Louis Stevenson features the title character, James Dury, falling in with a ship's crew led by a pirate called Teach?
Pass.
That's The Master of Ballantrae. And finally, a pirate named Tom Ayrton features in the novel In Search of the Castaways by which 19th century writer as part of his Extraordinary Voyages series?
Pass.
That's Jules Verne. 10 points for this. Spanish bayonet and Spanish dagger are species of what slow-growing, succulent plant often cultivated ornamentally? Its name can be spelled by concatenating the chemical symbols of yttrium, uranium, carbon and calcium.
Sheffield Gibson.
Yucca.
Yucca is correct. Well done. You get 3 questions on the German seasonal sweetmeats known as Lebkuchen. Lebkuchen are predominantly sweetened using what ingredient, the principal sweetener available in Europe during the Middle Ages?
Honey?
Honey is correct. Secondly, the second largest city in Bavaria, which city is the biggest exporter of Lebkuchen?
Any city in Bavaria?
I don't know.
Strasbourg.
No, it's Nuremberg. Thirdly, Berner Honig Lebkuchen are decorated with an image of what animal, a symbol of the Swiss capital?
Bear.
Bear is correct. Right, we're going to take a music round now. You're going to hear a piece of popular music. For 10 points, I want you to tell me the name of the artist singing.
There'll be blue.
Sheffield Gibson.
Oh, no. Sorry.
Nottingham Matthew.
Vera Lynn.
Vera Lynn is correct, yes. That was The White Cliffs of Dover, sung by Vera Lynn, who died in June 2020. Your music bonuses are three more Vera Lynn songs. In each case, I want you to give me the name of the song. Firstly...
When true lovers meet in Mayfair, so the legends tell. Songbirds sing, winter turns to spring. Every winding street in Mayfair falls beneath the spell. I know such enchantment can be.
Is it a nightingale sang in Berkeley Square? Is it a nightingale sang in Berkeley Square?
Nightingale sang in Berkeley Square.
Correct. Secondly...
Though I'm going on my way, don't feel so sad at heart. Keep this lovely moment as a memory apart. And before I go, please whisper soft and low, just once for me.
We'll meet again.
No. It's wish me luck as you wave me goodbye. Finally.
So will you please say hello to the folks that I know. Tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing this song.
We'll meet again.
It is We'll Meet Again, yes. 10 points for this. Native to Southeast Europe and Asia, the roots of the plant Glycyrrhiza glabra are used commercially to make what item of confectionery associated with the Yorkshire town of Pontefract?
Nottingham Matthews.
Licorice.
Licorice is correct, yes. You get three questions on buildings of scientific interest. In the Chantry Garden, Church Lane, Berkeley, in Gloucestershire, is a thatched hut that belonged to which English surgeon? It was in this hut in 1796 that the 8-year-old James Phipps received the first smallpox vaccine.
Jennings.
No, it's Edward Jenner. Bad luck. 14 India Street in Edinburgh is the birthplace of which 19th century scientist best known for his formulation of electromagnetic theory? It now houses the foundation named after him.
James Clerk Maxwell.
It's James Clerk Maxwell, which is what you were told. That's correct, yes. Now a museum, the Wakes in Hampshire was the family home of which 18th century naturalist? It was here that he wrote the Natural History and Antiquities of Selborne.
Gilbert White.
Gilbert White is what you were told. That's correct, yes. 10 points for this. Born in 1818, the British civil engineer Eugenius Birch is best known for what general kind of structure, surviving examples being at Aberystwyth, Hastings and Eastbourne?
Sheffield Pentelo.
Funicular?
No. Anyone want to buzz from Nottingham?
Nottingham Wood.
Pier.
Correct, yes. Seaside Piers. Your bonuses are on prominent people whose surnames start with or consist of the name of an alcoholic drink. In each case, identify the person from the description. Firstly, a former Defence Secretary and Member of Parliament for Enfield Southgate and later Kensington and Chelsea. Since 2005, he's pursued a broadcasting career.
That's Portillo. Michael Portillo.
Michael Portillo.
Correct. Second, the German fashion designer and photographer, best known as the creative director of the French fashion house Chanel and the Italian house Fendi until his death in 2019.
Karl Lagerfeld.
Karl Lagerfeld is correct. And finally, the US cultural anthropologist and author of the 1928 work Coming of Age in Samoa.
US cultural anthropologist. I don't know any US cultural anthropologists.
Margaret. Her first name is Margaret, but I can't get beyond it.
Keep going on the alcoholic beverage.
Come on.
I don't know.
No. No, pass.
Her first name is Margaret. It's Margaret Mead. 10 points for this. For what novel did Maggie O'Farrell win the 2020 Women's Prize for
Sheffield
Fiction?
Deacon.
Hamnet.
Hamnet is correct. Well done. Your bonuses are on stage musicals inspired by classical works. Give the title in each case. Based largely on the music of Borodin with lyrics by Robert Wright and George Forrest, which musical is an Arabian Nights-like adventure about a poet who battles a vizier of police?
Pass.
It's Kismet. Loosely based on Puccini's La Bohème, which rock musical by Jonathan Larson premiered in 1996 and concerns impoverished young artists in Manhattan's East Village?
Rock of Ages?
No, it's Rent. And finally, with a two-word title, which musical premiered in 1943 and is a revision of an opera by Bizet with lyrics by Oscar Hammerstein II? It was performed by an all-black cast.
Sorry, pass.
That's Carmen Jones. Right, we're going to take another picture round for you. A picture starter, you'll see a still from a television film. For 10 points, give me the name of the actor and the character they're playing.
Sheffield Pentelo.
David Suchet, Hercule Poirot.
Correct. Hercule Poirot celebrated in 2020 the centenary of his debut in print. For your picture bonuses, you're going to see three more actors playing the role. In each case, I want you to give me the name of the actor. Firstly...
Any idea? Pass.
That's Peter Ustinov. Secondly...
Pass.
That's Albert Finney. And finally...
John Malkovich.
John Malkovich is correct, yes. Right, 10 points for this. In chess, what four-letter word denotes a tactic in which a single piece attacks two or more pieces at the same time? Come on. None of you know, I'll tell you. It's a fork. 10 points for this. Listen carefully. Plinlimmon. The highest point in mid Wales is the source of two of the five longest rivers in the United Kingdom. For 10 points, name both.
Nottingham Hopkins.
Severn and Wye.
That's correct, yes. Right, your bonuses this time are on Katherine Johnson, one of the African-American human computers at NASA, who died in 2020. Johnson's reputation was established when which astronaut asked her to verify that his computer planned trajectory was correct. He was the first American to orbit Earth.
John Glenn.
John Glenn.
John Glenn is correct. Johnson contributed calculations to help sync the lunar module with the Lunar Orbiting Command and Service Module for which mission completed in 1969?
12.
Apollo 11. 11. 11.
Apollo 11. Apollo 11 is correct. Taraji P. Henson played Johnson in which 2016 film based on a group biography by Margot Lee Shetterly?
Hidden Figures. I think it's Hidden Figures. Hidden Figures.
Hidden Figures.
Hidden Figures is correct. What weapon is associated with the Hindu god Shiva, the flag of Barbados, the emblem of the car manufacturer Maserati, and the personification of Britannia?
Nottingham Wood.
A scimitar.
No. Anyone like to buzz from Sheffield?
Sheffield Gibson.
Spear.
No, it's a trident. 10 points for this. In 2019, what substance was detected in the atmosphere of the exoplanet K2-18b, a planet with roughly 8 times...
Sheffield Gibson.
Ammonia.
No. You lose 5 points. Roughly 8 times the mass of Earth and orbiting within the habitable zone of its red dwarf primary star.
Nottingham Wood.
Hydrogen.
No, it's water vapour. 10 points for this. Associated with the Barbizon painter Jean-François Millet, what is the largest port on the Cotentin Peninsula situated to the east of the Channel Islands?
Nottingham Hopkins.
Le Havre.
No, anyone want to buzz from Sheffield?
Sheffield Gibson.
Brest.
No, it's Cherbourg. 10 points for this. The name of which hero of Greek mythology can be spelled using the initial letters of 5 consecutive months of the year?
Sheffield Gibson.
Jason.
Jason is correct. Well done. July, August, September, October and November. Right, your bonuses are on fictional countries. In each case, identify the book in which the country described first appears. Firstly, Ruritania, a small country in Central Europe that first appeared in a novel of 1894 about an Englishman who impersonates an abducted king.
Pass.
That's The Prisoner of Zenda. Secondly, the Duchy of Grand Fennec, the smallest nation in the world. It declares war against the United States, expecting to lose and thereby get rehabilitation aid. That was the mouse that roared. And at the gong, Nottingham have 145, Sheffield have 70. Well, I'm afraid you were really trashed there, Sheffield. Bad luck. Nottingham, 145 is a pretty good score. You could come back as one of the 4 highest scoring winners. We'll see. Thank you very much for joining us, and thank you very much for joining us too, Sheffield. I hope you can join us next time for another first-round match, but until then, it's goodbye from Sheffield University.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Goodbye. Goodbye.
It's goodbye from Nottingham University.
Goodbye. Goodbye.
And it's goodbye from me. Goodbye.